You're listening to the Faith Fight Podcast. Today's episode is on what pleases God. Hello again, everybody. Thank you for tuning in to this episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. I'm your host, Chris Creary, and I'm here to help you get your prayers answered, to encourage you to grow from glory to glory, and to ultimately assist you in achieving your God-given purpose. And I'm grateful that you took time out of your day to listen to this episode where we're going to talk about what pleases God. If this is your first time listening, thank you for joining. I hope that you subscribe if you feel that this episode was a blessing to you. By subscribing, you will be sure to get every single episode that I release on a Monday morning when I release it. And you can start your day and your week off right. And if this isn't your first time listening, thank you for coming back and listening to this episode. If you know anyone else that will be blessed by this episode, be sure to share it with them so that they can listen to it, be blessed and encouraged and built up as a result of it as well. But today we're going to talk about what pleases God. Now the Bible says in Proverbs 16 verse 7, when a man's ways pleases the Lord, he makes even his enemies to be at peace with him. So in today's episode, we're going to talk about what pleases God. I'm going to find what the Bible says about what is pleasing to God so that we can have some things or some areas in our lives to focus on so that we can do those things and live a life that is pleasing to God. So I'm going to go over some verses. I hope you have your Bible ready and we're going to jump into it right now. The first verse that we're going to read is Hebrews 11 verse 6. It says, and without faith, it is impossible to please him. For whoever would draw near to God must believe that he exists and that he's a rewarder for those who seek him. Now, many of us know this verse, but when reading it, you need to ask yourself the question, why does faith please God? Now, I would answer that question by saying faith is confidence in God's power, his promises, and his tenderness towards his people. Therefore, you have to have faith to believe that God is God and that he is a rewarder of those who seek him diligently. And by doing this, you please God. Next, I'll read Romans 8 verse 8. It says, those who are in the flesh cannot please God. The reason why you are not able to please God when you operate in the flesh is because the flesh is sinful and perishing. Nothing done out of the flesh is able to be pure enough to be acceptable to God. Doing things in the flesh is like dressing up to go out to a dinner at a fancy restaurant without taking a shower. Yes, you might look good on the outside, but you are not clean where it matters the most. Now, the following verse that I'm going to read is from Hebrews 11 verse 16. It says, do not neglect to do good and to share what you have, for such sacrifices are pleasing to God. Now, acts of kindness are when you give, serve, and help others. These acts oftentimes go unnoticed by other people, but God sees your sacrifice and is pleased when you show love for others this way in his name. And I'll read Psalms 19 verse 14. It says, let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. Now, there's a connection with your heart and what comes out of your mouth. What you meditate on in your heart will eventually come out of your mouth. This is why it's not only important to watch what you say, but also to watch what you meditate on, what you think about in your heart. In meditating on the word of God, it is pleasing to him because eventually your words and actions will be in line with the word of God. Now, the next verse I'll read is Colossians 1, verse 10. It says, for this reason, since the day we heard about you, we have not stopped praying for you. We continually ask God to fill you with the knowledge of his will through all wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives, so that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and please him in every way, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God. Now, when you bear godly fruit, do good works and grow in your knowledge of God, it is pleasing to God. This doesn't happen by accident, but you have to diligently and purposefully set time aside to serve other people, to study the word of God, and to fellowship with him in worship. Now, the next verse I'll read is Galatians 2 verse 20. It says, I've been crucified with Christ and I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. The life I now live in the body, I live by faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me. Now, it's pleasing to God when we dedicate our lives to living for Christ. Our Christian life begins when we die to our old life and live according to God's word. Next, I read Psalms 51, verses 16 to 17. It says, "You do not desire a sacrifice, or I would offer one. You do not want a burnt offering. The sacrifice you desire is a broken spirit. You will not reject a broken and repentant heart, O God." Now, you can never please God by outward actions if your inward heart attitude is not right, no matter how good the action is. God is pleased by the genuine humility that you show when you are truly sorry for your sins and intend to stop and repent. Now I'll read Psalms 147, verses 10 to 11. It says, "He takes no pleasure in the strength of a horse or in human might. No, the Lord's delight is in those who fear him, those who put their hope in his unfailing love." Now, we spend a lot of time and effort to sharpen our skills and increase our strength. Now, there is nothing wrong in doing that. And in fact, our gifts and our talents and abilities can be used to glorify God. But when we use our skills with no regard for God, then they are indeed worth little. It is reverence to God and trust in God that he desires from us. Now, I'll read Micah 6, verse 8. It says, "He has shown you, O mortal, what is good. And what does the Lord require of you? To act justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with your God." What God wants from your life is obedience. He is a personal God and desires a personal relationship with you. He also expects you to love your neighbors by doing them good and ministering to their needs. Next, I'll read John 4, verse 23 to 24. It says, "But the time is coming, indeed it's here now, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. The Father is looking for those who will worship him in that way. For God is a spirit, so those who worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth." So one reason you might be looking for something is because you desire it or if it pleases you to have it. Now, this verse says that worship in spirit and truth is something that God is looking for. Now, the question now becomes, how can you provide that kind of worship to God? To worship God in spirit is to have a heart that is in pursuit of an intimate relationship with God. To worship him in truth is to worship God in a biblically accurate way. So keeping that in mind, you can worship God in spirit and in truth, and this pleases him, and he is actually looking for this from us. And now it's time to move into a moment of prayer concerning this episode. So I'm going to pray. You can listen to me if you're doing something that requires your direct attention, but if you can agree with me in prayer, that would be great. So let's pray. Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you as we come before your presence, Lord. We thank you for your grace, your mercies, and your unfailing, unending, supernatural, wonderful love for us, Lord. We thank you, Lord God, that there is nothing that can separate us from your love, Lord God. And where sin abound, grace did much more abound, Lord God. So we humbly come before your presence by the blood of Jesus, and because of his sacrifices, we ask you to forgive us and cleanse us, Lord, of all sins as we approach your throne of grace right now. And we thank you, Lord God, for your word, Lord God, as it gives understanding and revelation to us, Lord God, and helps us to live a successful Christian life. Our desire, Lord God, and the desire for all those listening right now is that we please you, Lord God, that we live a life that when you look down upon us, that you are smiling towards us, Lord God. So, Father, I pray, Lord God, that in all that we do, that we will operate in faith, Lord God, that we will have faith because your word says that without it, it's impossible to please you, Lord God. And I also pray for myself and every person listening, Lord God, that in everything that we do, that we don't do it in the flesh, but we do it out of our spirit, Lord God, just to please you, not because we want to boast or brag about ourselves or anything that we have done, but help us to do our good works and serve others, Lord God, out of love, out of our spirit, to be a blessing to others and give you glory, Father God. And help us, Father God, as we meditate on your word daily, Lord God, that your word may be alive and active inside of us, Lord God, that it may bear fruit in our lives, Lord God, as we meditate on it in our hearts, Lord God, that it may bring forth fruits in our actions and in everything that we do, Lord God. And as we study your word, Lord God, to grow in knowledge of you, Lord God, and grow in knowledge of your word and live our lives according to how you have ordained for us to live, Lord God. As Christians, Lord, I pray, Father God, that you will look down upon us and be pleased with our efforts, Lord God, as we desire to live a life that's pleasing to you, Father. I pray, Father God, that you will help us to live a life that is dedicated to you, Lord God, a life dedicated to serving the others, Lord God, a life fully submitted to Christ, Lord God, that you will be able to work through us, Lord God, and have your way in every area of our lives, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, that as we submit to you, Lord God, that you will be pleased with us, Lord God, that you will be drawn close to us as a result of our obedience towards your word and up to your commands that you have directed us, Lord God. And I thank you, Father, that you are faithful, Lord, that your Holy Spirit will direct us in everything that we do. So, Lord, I commit every single person listening right now into your hands. I pray that you would help us to do what's pleasing in your sight, Lord God. And thank you, Lord, that the blood of Jesus helps us to be in right standing with you, and that your perfect will shall be accomplished in our lives, Father. So I commit every single person listening to your hands. I pray, Lord, that you will help us to do what is pleasing towards you every single day, Lord God. And may we give you glory by doing the things that you have called us to do, Father. And we commit our lives and everything concerning us into your hands, and we pray, Lord, that you are glorified through it, Lord. So in the name of Jesus, we thank you and we pray right now. Amen. So that's it for this episode of the Faith Fight Podcast. I hope that you were blessed by it, and I pray that you will continue to do what you need to do so that you can put a smile on God's face. And remember, I have over 100 other episodes in the archives that you can listen to. If you need more encouragement about any different topic that I've covered so many different topics. So go into the archives. There's a link in the description of this episode that you can go to and listen to any episode that I have done in the past. You can download the customized prayer plan for that week or that topic, and you can use that as part of your daily devotions, and it will help you to draw closer to God. It will help you to bring structure and format to your devotional time if you don't know how to have one already. And the link is in the description if you want to get that customized prayer plan for this episode and for any other episodes that I've ever done. And remember to subscribe so that you can get every episode that I release on a Monday morning, and share this with someone else so that it can be a blessing to them. And I'm looking forward to hearing testimonies or a review of the podcast. If you're listening to it on Apple Podcasts, just go and write a review. Share how this podcast has been a blessing to you so that other people can see it and listen to it, and that it will be a blessing to them as well. And I pray that you will continue to be blessed and encouraged and built up by through listening to this podcast. And that's it for this episode. Remember, every single day, put on the full armor of Christ Jesus and go out and fight the good fight of faith. And you'll hear from me again next week on the Faith Fight Podcast. Be blessed, everyone.